Let's say you really want something, even if it's not a job, just believe in yourself. Hello and welcome back to my channel, Bessie. How are you doing? It's been a while since I've actually done a sit down chit chat get ready with me. I'm filming this look. It's a cute little everyday glam look that I like to wear. Just quick disclaimer, I do have a bit of a cold, so I do apologize. My eyelashes have fallen out, so ignore that. I did forget to show you guys what products I use for my brows. It is literally just this NYX microbrow pencil. I use this all the time. This is actually a holy grail. It's my favorite brow pencil. Been using this for like ever. So yeah, so stick around if you're interested in more, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. So I have already prepped my skin. Well, I say prepped, but I mean moisturized, because as soon as I get out of the shower, the first thing I do is moisturize my skin. I'm now gonna prime and just kind of get my skin ready for the makeup. I'm gonna start with this super cute, absolutely dirty mini Fenty Beauty primer. This is the instant retouch primer in I think it's their matte. It's matte. Yes, yeah, soft matte. Absolutely love this stuff. Like, I never used to be a matte makeup babe, but this has changed my makeup game. So normally what I like to do is just put a little bit on my finger, as if I can get it out. There you go. That's the amount I normally put on my finger. I normally rub it in together and warm it up, and I put it on the underneath my eyes, on my nose, on my forehead, my chin. I just like to rub that in. I actually like to massage it into my skin. Anything that I use on my skin, I always massage in. I've just been seeing like people massaging their faces, and their faces just reshape so perfectly well. And there's also this page on Instagram that I absolutely love. They're called Face Gym. It's like a gym for your face, where it's like facials that actually you see a huge improvement in your skin if you moisturize, like using massaging motions like this. So if you see me looking there, I'm actually looking at a little mirror because I can't really see myself in the viewfinder. I do wear glasses, so my eyesight is not the clearest, but yeah. Now I've moisturized that into my skin, it feels really lovely and actually quite hydrating considering it's a matte primer, but I do love this. So if you guys are interested in a really good primer, I would suggest this one. Looking quite prepped and moisturized. So the next thing I like to do is take my foundation, another Fenty Beauty product. This is the Pro Filter Foundation in 420. I love this stuff. I actually am obsessed. Like, it's medium to full coverage. Like, you can build it up. It's a really good buildable foundation, and it gives you that hydrating look. Considering I have put a matte primer on, it still gives me that hydration that I need in my skin. So for this, I just like pump it around my face like this. I do avoid underneath my eyes because that's where I like to keep my concealer. I don't really put anything underneath my eyes or spread the foundation out there. I'm just going to take my Real Techniques Seamless Complexion Foundation brush, which I love. It's like an angled tapered brush, and it really does such a good job at just spreading out the product evenly. It doesn't give me that really horrible like brush line that you get from like cheap brushes that you order on, like, let's say Amazon or AliExpress. And it just really spreads out the foundation really well. I then take a damp beauty blender. This is my absolute favorite beauty blender, also from Real Techniques. What I normally do is I take the product and I just tap it into the skin and just really make sure it presses and melts into the skin well. I also feel like this gives it a seamless finish. The next thing I like to do is take a lighter concealer. So I say lighter, it's not super light, it's maybe two shades lighter than my actual complexion. So with the concealer, I kind of like to spread it out here and here. And I go down the bridge of my nose, on my forehead, here, and literally just here. So now we've got more time to speak, let's have a chat. Let's just talk about general life, what's been going on. For me personally, so much has been going on, and I'm so grateful. It's like just good things, like, and I'm so happy and grateful for it all. I think we should talk about me moving back to the UK. Yes, I am back. I'm officially back home. Yeah, I moved back. I think it must have been 2 months now. So since December, I have been back in the UK, living life. I started an amazing new job. Let's just get blending while I talk. So I like to take this tapered, I call it a concealer brush from Real Techniques. It's actually called the pointed foundation brush. I actually got this in TK Maxx a couple years ago for like £2. It was in a set, so yeah, go pick this up. It's absolutely amazing. I love this brush. I'll just quickly zoom in for you guys. So yeah, let's talk about life. So I moved back in December. I moved back just before Christmas, literally the day before the 24th. So I've been here for a while, just getting settled into like life, moving into my flat, my new job. It's been a lot. I kind of want to tell you guys how I got my job. It's crazy. Like, I feel like I should do this in a whole nother separate video, but I feel like it would be nice to kind of just set you guys into my new life while I'm doing my makeup. Why not? I had actually applied for this job while I was doing my master's. This was in July. So as you guys know, I was putting out like master's content and it wasn't resonating. Let's just put it that way. It wasn't making sense. Master's degree, it was in marketing and brand management. Absolutely loved the degree. I did it at my old university. If you guys don't know, I went to Kingston University in London. It was a great experience. Like the teaching, it was like doing The Apprentice but in university. It was so cool, honestly. I loved that degree. I made some really great friends. We still keep in touch. My course was all online, so I didn't get the opportunity to meet my future husband, but he's coming, I can tell you that. I was doing my master's and in July I had started applying for jobs. I thought, you know what, this is perfect, probably the perfect time to start applying now. I'm coming to the end of my degree and I'm about to start writing my dissertation. So as job applications go, you apply, you wait to hear something. Almost all of the jobs I had applied to, I got rejected from. So it was no, 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 no. And I was like, okay, what am I going to do with my life? My mum was just like, keep applying. And she actually suggested to me, so I always wanted to work at Vogue magazine. My mum was like, go and apply to them. And just to give you a backstory, I had applied to them before in my undergrad to do a graduate scheme with them. So yeah, I didn't get that job, obviously. That's one of the reasons why I went back to uni, because I thought, well, you know, maybe doing a master's will help enhance my skills, which yes, it definitely did. I can guarantee you that. I feel like I've learned so much more about marketing and just what I really, really love. So yeah. Anyway, she goes, she tells me to apply. I find this really cool job in social media that they had going on, and they were hiring at the time. So I then decided to apply for that same job. I got invited to an interview, so it was the first job that I was actually invited to an interview for. It was the first job that I actually got an interview for. So I went to the interview, it was absolutely great. They invited me to the second stage of the interview. I had to do a presentation, and in this presentation, they wanted me to create a media plan, or like how I would plan the social media for their titles, what sort of KPIs they'd meet, and KPIs are key performing indicators. So it's like little objectives that a client, let's say, would come to us and ask for it to be achieved. So let's say the KPI is impressions or reach on Instagram, then I would suggest X, Y, and Z for it to be successful, right? Presentation went amazingly well. I love presenting. Like, I think I'm a people person, I would like to say. I do well, like, explaining things, suggesting things. So as the time goes on, they ask me some questions. It was basically about numbers, and I'll be totally honest with you guys, I'm not the best when it comes to numbers. Like, maths is okay. Like, I'm okay with my maths, but when it comes to actually putting those numbers into fruition and making it make sense, yeah, I sometimes have a problem thinking on the spot. So they asked me a few questions about how I would budget something else quite similar to what I presented. I'm going in with a deeper concealer. This is the e.l.f. Hydrating Concealer. This is in the shade Rich Chocolate. absolutely love this concealer. Super, 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 super hydrating, which I like. So it gives me that dewy finish as well. So I just dab a dot onto my cheek. It helps contour. And I'm just going to contour with another Real Techniques brush. This is the Expert Face Brush. You can see it's a lot denser. It's not tapered, but it kind of is. But yeah, really great brush, love it. So yeah, he then asked me a question about the budgeting and how I would budget. And I'm thinking to myself, fuck, I don't know what I would do here. So I just plucked some numbers out of thin air and thought, oh, this will work, this will be useful to share. Yeah, probably the worst thing I could have possibly done in an interview. I looked so stupid. I got it completely wrong. I really, and yeah, sadly embarrassed myself. And they were like, that was the end of the interview. What a way to finish off an interview. I heard back from them and I didn't get the job, which was totally fine. It made sense because I didn't know what I was talking about in that last instance. Like, it was just that one question that threw me off that I didn't know an answer to. And I think in that moment, I should have said, I honestly don't know the answer to this. However, I would be willing to go and research this. I think that's what they probably wanted from me. I didn't get the job and they took that same job down. I assumed they'd probably hired someone or whatever. Come, was it mid-October, which is when I was back in the UK, I came for my sister. She was moving back to London as well. She was coming to university. So I was obviously job hunting at the time. I was currently not jobless. I still had a job, but it's not my career. It was not what I wanted to do in life, you know? It was just a simple job at my university. Time passes, the job's then up on a different job board, which I'd never heard of. And if it wasn't for one of my friends, Alice, you guys probably seen her in my other videos, she suggested I go and look at Dots, which is a really cool job application site, kind of similar to LinkedIn, very similar. So I applied to the same job again, I reapplied, and I sent them an email just saying that I had gone and done all of the research necessary for this role, especially in where I was lacking. So I just went back to them. It's kind of like going back to an ex. It was like, I still like you, I've worked on myself, I can take this relationship, I really want this relationship. It was kind of like that. But for a job, I would never go back to an ex like that. I'd obviously sent that email to the HR manager telling her that I'd seen the same job back up. Is it possible for me to reapply? She went back to the team. She said Amelia's come back and she wants to come back for another interview. She was like, yeah, they're actually hiring for the position again, because at the time they didn't find anyone. I was like, wow, God is working in my favor. This is definitely for me. Went back and they said, we're not going to interview you again. We're just going to have a chit chat. We kind of want to know what you've been up to, what have you been doing, and why did you want to come back for another interview? I basically just explained, like, I've gone and done all the research necessary. I've gone and learned what I was lacking last time, and I really feel like this job is for me. They asked me what I did, so I went through every stage of how I've learned what I was lacking. They were impressed. They were actually quite intrigued with my responses, because I actually had answers or responses that made sense. So when it came to like budgeting and stuff, I actually went and taught myself that, and I created a little budget for myself so that I was on top of my own finances. Like, it was just kind of like meant to be. Like, I just thought, this is gonna help me one day in the future, let me just do it. I'm just gonna set my face, by the way, using the Laura Mercier translucent powder. Absolutely love this stuff. I'm sure you guys have seen me use this before. To set, I'm not baking, I'm just setting. I'm going to use this Real Techniques contour, what? It's called a contour brush, but I don't use it to contour. I obviously walked them through everything that I did, and they were pretty impressed, and they were like, okay, well, you'll hear back from us. Come a couple weeks later, I'm checking the job board and I see the job's gone. I thought, oh, maybe the job's gone. So I pranked my mum and I was like, mum, I got the job, they called me, blah, blah, blah. My mum was like, no way. I was like, yeah, they called me. And then I was like, ha 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 ha, joking, I'm just pranking you. Literally 10 minutes later, I got an email from the hiring manager saying, hi, we want to speak with you really quickly about the job. I sent her my mobile number. And she calls me and she's like, the interviewers are really impressed with how tenacious and hardworking you are. The fact that you went back and learned everything that you were lacking really struck a chord and they want to hire you. What? They want to hire me? I knew that they wanted to hire me. Let's just put it that way. I just had a feeling, like my intuition that day was like 10 out of 10 because it was the fact that I pranked my mum 10 minutes before I had opened my emails. It was meant to be. And I hadn't checked my emails until my mum came home. So how funny, how ironic. I was just like, wow, this is so cool. I'm so happy. Like, got my dream job. I'm currently working my dream job. I'm working at the company I've always wanted to work for since uni. I'm loving life. Like, everything that I've wanted is just coming my way and I couldn't be more grateful. I'm gonna quickly bronze using the Juvia's Place bronzing palette in dark. Yep, in dark. I love this bronzing palette. I'm just gonna use this top shade here. Sometimes I use this one, but we're not going that deep. We're gonna use this top one. I'm just gonna press that into my skin. I love this bronzer. That's how I got my dream job. It's actually just so exciting. Such a great like story to tell. And I really do hope this inspires some of you. Like, let's say you really want something, even if it's not a job, just believe in yourself. Like, you can do it. You can have what you want. So it's just one of those things that you just have to persevere and see the good in every situation. Like, literally, I know it sounds so cliche and really like cringy, but sometimes you actually have to see the good in every situation. For me, in that situation, that was not the right time for me to do that job, because when my dissertation came, I was having sleepless nights, I was stressed, I was confused, I was tired, I gained a lot of weight, and that was just within the period of writing my dissertation. Imagine taking on a full-time job while writing my dissertation. It wasn't the right time, and God had a greater plan for me, and I couldn't be more grateful. So yeah, it's just really cool being able to tell you guys this story. Anyway, I'm just gonna quickly take my blusher, which is from the Revolution Pop Spice palette. As you can see, it's broken, I dropped it, but thankfully the pans are still intact. I'm actually gonna mix the orange with the really cute pink blush there using a MAC blush. Well, it's not actually a blush brush, but I use this to blush, so yeah. Press it into my skin. I don't do too much blush, but as you can see, that's how I do my blush. Just brush it up. Thank you so much if you've watched it to the end. If you guys want to see more of like my manifestation videos, then stay tuned and leave a comment down below and let me know what else you want to hear about. I love sharing these stories and yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!